Hello, guys and girls, and welcome back to more Dishonored. When we last left off, my HD PVR wanted to be retarded and freeze, and I was sitting here playing the game, killing people, just moving on along with the campaign, and I look up at my laptop, and it's frozen. So, out in the middle of all that, I was talking to this guy. I don't know what his name is, but it's like Admiral Hackett, I think. But I'm not sure. But anyway, I was talking to him, and in order for me to fix the problem that happened last time, I had to reset my laptop. So whenever I resume this game, it's he's going to be in the middle of his sentence. So just wanted to heads up everybody on that.
Called when he needed help. The Golden Cat, of all places. A bathhouse for aristocrats. Little better than a cursed brothel.
But there's an unfortunate twist. It appears that Pendleton's own kinsmen stand in our way. Twins, Morgan and Custis. Not only are they controlling Emily, but they have the controlling parliamentary votes we so desperately need.
Yes, the Pendletons have to die. But most importantly, Emily must be brought here safely so we can protect her until the Lord Regent and his entourage have been dealt with. Pendleton's waiting for you on the dock. He's asked to brief you personally. I think it's best.
I'm gonna try and keep a close eye on the laptop this time. Make sure it doesn't freeze again.
A moment, if I may. Ah, the Royal Protector. Just the man I needed to speak with. Corvo, I've asked to speak to you myself. You see, I'm sending you to kill my older brothers, Morgan and Custis. They're horrible men. It's true, as you may have heard, cruel beyond words. Further, my brothers are close allies to the Lord Regent, and as long as they are in Parliament, we cannot gather the votes we'll need to stop the Lord Regent from further consolidating his power. These days, they're best known for exploiting their favor with him to cheat others out of their wealth. Let's just say that not every family evicted in quarantine for having the plague actually has the plague. I warned my brothers in every way I could. I really did. But they never did listen to me. They'll be at the Golden Cat tonight at their usual revels. They'll be protected by the city watch, so it'll be dangerous. Now go. Please do it before I change my mind.
Yeah, just random guy walks by while I'm trying to have a conversation with this guy. Hey, dude, what's up?
I'll take you to the Golden Cat when you're ready. I've taken Lord Pendleton enough times, believe me.
Get you as close as I can to the Golden Cat, Corvo. You'll have to go the rest of the way on your own. The entrance is near Holker Square. The main thing is to make sure that little girl, Emily, gets back all safe and sure. Them two Pendletons are there, so I'm guessing there'll be a lot of guards. Slackjaw might have some ideas on helping you get inside the cat if he don't kill you. This here's his territory. He and his Bottle Street gang hole up at the old Dunwall Whiskey Factory. They sell the elixir that folks use to fight off the plague. I'll lay low, but keep an eye out for you and the little lady you bring back. Good luck to you. I know Emily must mean a lot to you. Be careful going up the street, Corvo. A river hand I know pulled up alongside me last night and said there's one of those watchtowers on Clavering now. Guess you getting rid of Campbell shook up the Lord Regent.
I feel like I was just here. Like, he was crouched down right here, and I had to walk past all this. Wow. Okay, so I'm gonna try and be sneaky. Like, that's gonna happen. I'm probably gonna have the worst ending possible. He was taking a pee.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Thaddeus Campbell, formerly High Overseer, is no longer a citizen of Dunwall. He now bears the Heretic's brand. By one of the oldest traditions of the Abbey of the Everyman, it is now a minor criminal offense to offer this man aid or housing. In this time of spiritual crisis, the Overseers have initiated the Feast of Painted Kettles until a new High Overseer is chosen.
Anything in your pocket for a poor working man, huh, pal?
Hey, you're just the man I's looking for. Slackjaw's wanting to talk to you.
Oh, wow. I gotta go in the building first for that.
That him? Yeah, he's the one. Hey, we got a message for you from Slackjaw. He wants to talk at the distillery.
Are you guys bad? Entering neutral zone, so I shouldn't have enemies here. These guys should all be friendly, correct? You good? Yeah, we good. We good, boy.
Slackjaw be waiting for you. Easy, easy.
you heard? Slackjaw keeps the good stuff for himself. Rest of us get one part elixir, three parts water. Oh, that's just to make the swallowing more smooth. Well, I ain't taking no chances on getting the plan. Drink till you drop, that's my motto.
Wonder why there's that random chain there.
Hey! Psh.
All I hear is guys with crap in their throats just a coughing away. I just went in a freaking circle.
My men were right. You do look like a man out for murder. Way I figure it, there ain't nobody worth killing around here except those two Pendletons over at the Golden Cat. I'm right, ain't I? See, Slackjaw knows. Them boys are twins. Rich, mean, and weird. Worse than most of their ilk. They've been laying low there a while, not sure why. There's a lot of security at the Golden Cat tonight, though. Special guests and the like. But you're gonna walk in there, dressed like that, and kill the Pendleton brothers? Maybe I got a better way to take care of them, too. If you're doing something for me first, understand? Someone, I don't know who, is killing my men, taking my territory,
probably
stealing
me.
My goods. Might be a fellow named Galvani. I sent my best man to investigate, but he went missing and... Well, now I need someone to find what happened to him. Go to this Galvani's place. He lives nearby off Clavering Boulevard. You do that for me, and I'll get you a better way into the Golden Cat.
Pick it up. God.
Thank you.
Oh my god, the freaking video froze again. Are you kidding me? This is aggravating. Well, I guess you didn't see anything that happened at all, did you? I don't really understand why it keeps freaking freezing like this. I apologize over and over and over for this crap happening to you guys, but I don't know what to do to fix it. So, I guess, until next time, guys and girls, everybody have a fantastic day. Peace.